In this video, a complete guide with everything you need to know to have an amazing holiday in Lanzarote. Hi everyone, my name's Yves and this is what I do. I create holiday and travel guides. Also for Lanzarote, I traveled all over the island, went to all the different holiday destinations, found out which hotels you should stay at, which you definitely should not stay at, what you should do on the island, what is not worth doing, when you should go, and a lot more. Everything you find out in this video, where I give you the perfect guide for anyone traveling to Lanzarote so you can have the best holiday possible on Lanzarote. In the first part of this video, I want to give you a quick overview of all the different holiday destinations on Lanzarote so you can pick the right holiday destination for you in Lanzarote. Also, I want to give you an overview of the top 10 best hotels. I visited over 45 on Lanzarote, and in this video I just quickly want to show you the top 10 so you can pick also a great hotel. You can also find the full list of the hotels I selected on my website checkedholidays.com, but in this video I just try to keep it short, so only the top 10 hotels. The first destination I want to cover in Lanzarote is the one closest to the airport. This one is Matagorda. It's a very small place with just a few hotels and bungalow complexes just outside of Puerto del Carmen. You also have bars, restaurants and a few shops here, but not that many. It's all very centrally located. This is also one of the good things about this resort, that everything is within easy walking distance. If you want some more bars, restaurants or even to go clubbing or some more active nightlife, then Puerto del Carmen is within easy walking distance. As I mentioned, next to Matagorda you have Puerto del Carmen. This is one of the bigger holiday destinations on the island. There's many different nice beaches to choose from here. There's a great active nightlife scene as well, so there's many things to do also in the evening here. Like, you can go shopping in the shopping center, there's clubs, there's live performances in many of the places, there's great restaurants to go out and eat. So all in all, I think this is definitely one of the most interesting places for those who like to have the more active nightlife buzzing scene. You can find this best in Puerto del Carmen. Also in the Puerto del Carmen, you will find three of my top 10 hotels. This is the Las Costas, first of all. It's a great compact little hotel that is, I think, one of the best choices on Lanzarote for a beach holiday. If you like a beach holiday in a compact feeling cozy hotel, then this is great for you. There's also a glass wall, which is kind of like sheltered from the wind, and the pool behind it is really nice to escape from the windy days you sometimes have in Lanzarote. And also near this hotel, you have great nightlife nearby, so for all these reasons, definitely a great place to go on holiday if you want a beach holiday hotel in Lanzarote. Then there's also the Los Jaimos Hotel in this area, which is really what I would call a very unique holiday vibe this hotel has. It really feels inviting and fresh and summery. I can't really explain how, but it just feels really good in this hotel. Also, it's very family oriented, so it's got really loads of things to do for the kids, lots of entertainment, and it's also very close to the airport, but still far enough away from it not to hear it or to be disturbed by it. So it's really good for a family holiday in Lanzarote or in Puerto del Carmen. Then there's also the Lani Suite Deluxe, great for a luxuriously feeling holiday. It's very attentive staff in this hotel, so really for personal luxury you can come here. Everyone will know exactly what you want, how you want it, and really cater to all your needs in this hotel. It's also centrally located, so if you do like to go out, there's lots of nightlife and great restaurants nearby, and it's really for adults only. So if you like adults only holiday with a luxurious vibe, then this is the ideal place for you in Puerto del Carmen. Then the next holiday destination on Lanzarote is the Puerto Cayero. It's a little bit of a weird place, I would say. It's all about quiet and relaxation in this area. There is only two real hotels here. The rest is residential in this area. Near the port you will also find many restaurants and shops, but there ain't really what I would call a beach here in this area. The next holiday destination on Lanzarote is the Playa Blanca. This is not a great destination, a bit further to the south. It's similar to what Puerto del Carmen has to offer, but very different in other ways. While Puerto del Carmen feels more like a town with hotels mixed in, Playa del Blanca just has a small town core with huge hotels, very modern and new hotels all around. In size, there are many huge hotels here compared to the Puerto del Carmen, that is more of the smaller and compact complexes.
The Playa Blanca is also a little bit of a strange destination because the Playa Blanca is one big giant resort, but it's broken up into smaller beaches and smaller little destinations, smaller little towns and smaller groups of like restaurants. The main big area is more the town area and towards the port area. So do check before online if you're booking where exactly your hotel or accommodation is, that it is close to the places you like to be, because otherwise it can be a quite far walk, especially from one end of the resort to the other end of the resort. For some people, it's just a very long walk. I wouldn't call it walking distance anymore. So definitely, if you're going here, either check where your hotel is or book a car so you can get around easily. Some hotels in my top 10 that I can definitely advise because they're in a great location would be the Mar Comfort Atlantic Gardens. This is a small all-inclusive hotel. It's very budget-friendly and it's really aimed at adults-only holidays. So for an adults-only holiday, all-inclusive, great location, budget-friendly, then the Mar Comfort is ideal for you. Then there's also the Gran Tagoro or the Gran Castillo Tagoro. This is great for those traveling on a family holiday. There's lots to see and do in this hotel for kids. Also great entertainment. And there's also our own like little private pool beach in this hotel, which is also very fun for the children. And it's great all-inclusive in this hotel as well. So all-inclusive, beach in the hotel, lots of fun for the entire family. Gran Castillo Tagoro is your ideal choice in the Playa Blanca. The next hotel is the Princesa Yaiza. This is in one of the best places of all of these hotels. It's right next to the most beautiful beach as well. It's a 5-star plus hotel, so a little bit on the higher end of the budget, I would say, quite upscale. But in this category, it's also one of the best hotels on the island to travel with children. So if you like luxury, 5-star plus, be close to the beach and traveling with your children, this could be the best choice for you. Then also in my top 10 is the THE Volcan Lanzarote. This is a great hotel close to the marina, so most of the nice restaurants are here. There's also the market, so if you like to be in this area of the Playa Blanca, this could be ideal for you. The hotel itself is very authentic and very much like the towns in Lanzarote, the design and the layout. Also, this means that there's many little different pools spread throughout, so you always feel like you're having a private holiday, I would say. It's a little bit not like a giant hotel where everyone is around one pool. No, you just feel like you're on holiday in this small, little, authentic Lanzarote village with pools spread all throughout. So, great hotel as well. Then there's also the Iberostar Lanzarote Park. This is a great hotel, close to the beach, lots of entertainment for the entire family, for all age categories in this hotel, and is definitely one of the more family-friendly hotels in the Playa Blanca as well. The Playa Blanca is very big. Most of the hotels on the island are here. That's also why there's so many of the hotels in my top 10 list. Also, the Sando San Blas is one of them here in the Playa Blanca. It's a huge hotel, one of the biggest ones on the island. It's great for those who like an all-inclusive holiday where you don't really need to leave your hotel for anything. Everything you can want is within the hotel. Also, nearby, you will find the Playa Mujeres, where you have a nice beach if you like to go to the beach as well. The Costa Teguise is kind of a combination of the Puerto del Carmen and the Playa Blanca, I would say. It got the beaches of the Puerto del Carmen and also the more cozy townish feel of the Puerto del Carmen, but then it got the bigger hotels from the Playa Blanca, so it's kind of a combination of the two. In the daytime, most of the people here spend logically on the beach, and in the evening, everyone comes together in the cozy kind of Pueblo Marinero, where you will find most of the restaurants and bars. Then there's also Arrecife, which is the capital of Lanzarote. There's not really so much to see or do here, but it's really cheap to eat, stay or drink in this area. It's just a town like many other, a city like many others. However, it has a great beach, the Playa del Reducto, and a great hotel, the Arrecife Gran Hotel and Spa. Arrecife on its own, because of its central location on the island, could also make for a great place for you to explore the island from. If you do like to rent a car and explore the island, this might be your best destination to stay and explore the entire island from. As I mentioned, here you also find a great hotel in my top 10 list of hotels on Lanzarote, the Arrecife Gran Hotel. This is a great place to explore the rest of the island from. It also got amazing views over the oceans from all of the rooms, and it also got a large spa to enjoy and relax in.
In this part of this video, I quickly want to run over some things to do while you are in Lanzarote. Even though the island ain't that big, there's lots of things to see and discover. In this part, I'm going to cover that a little bit in a summary. I'm going to run over it quite quickly. If you want to know more about these things in details, know you can find more on my website, it's checkedholidays.com.
So one of the things you should definitely go to on Lanzarote, in my opinion, especially if you're traveling with a family, is to go to see the Rancho Texas. This I can definitely advise because there's lots of things to see and do here. There's like a little bit of a zoo, live animal show, and water parks as well here to enjoy, plus much, much more. Rancho Texas, I would definitely advise for any family traveling to Lanzarote. The El Diablo restaurant in Lanzarote is one of these unique experiences you can only get here on the island. Where else can you get a volcano baked chicken? The food is nice and the surroundings really quite amazing. Don't want to eat, but just want to see some demonstrations of the power of the volcanoes at work. Then make sure to visit the Montañas del Fuego, where you can see demonstrations are given about the power of the volcanoes. Impressive to see for young and old. One of the things I really want to advise you to do on the island is to go snorkeling, even though maybe you might not be a fan of it or you've never done it before. This is really the place to try it. Not only are there many different excursions offering this, but you can also go snorkeling yourself and you're pretty much for sure to see a lot of sea life. This is mostly because there's a very rocky surface here. There's not so much sand, which makes that the water is very clear and it has a really unique sea habitat. So if you're going to go snorkeling, maybe here is the place for you to try it for the first time. If you want to go a little bit on an adventure, then take a dolphin watching tour here on the Atlantic Ocean surrounding Lanzarote. There's many different boat companies offering these type of excursions. And while you are pretty much for sure gonna see actual dolphins, however, it's not 100% guarantee, but pretty much for sure that you are, make sure that you pick a great boat for the best chance of seeing them. Also, better boats offer lots of fun stuff to do also along the way. Lanzarote is really dry, dusty and rough terrain. Because of this, it makes it also ideal to do some off-roading. There are many different options to do so and many different companies offering these kind of options. But make sure you go with a good company so you will actually spend time off-roading and not just driving on the paved roads. You can go either by buggy, by quad or by Jeep Safari. There's many great options out there. Just pick the right company and read reviews before online to make sure that you have the right company.
Lanzarote has lots of different beaches to choose from. In this part, I want to talk about my top 5 beaches you should visit while you're on holiday in Lanzarote.
Number 5, near the Matagorda area, you have the Playa Lima. The beach here is not so amazing. The main reason I would want to advise this is for having a family holiday. Then this is quite nice, especially for children. They seem to have a lot of fun here because of the planes that are landing nearby. This is my main reason of advising it. But there's also a nice little shopping center behind it where you can have a nice dinner and a nice lunch. And this is also one of the more relaxed beaches in this area. So if you're staying in the Puerto del Carmen and just want to escape, go to Matagorda near the Playa Lima, where normally the beaches are much less busy. On number 4, you have the Playa del Reducto near the Arrecife, Arrecife being the capital. Playa del Reducto is a completely man-made beach. It got this perfect white sand. So if you're looking for that kind of look and feel, then this is the ideal beach, like the typical ideal white sand beach. There's also many great restaurants here. And the good thing is, because this area is not very touristy, there's many very cheap restaurants and very nice, authentic Spanish tapas and stuff you can eat here. So for all these reasons, could be a great time to visit the Playa del Reducto. If you want to rough it a bit more, then all the way away from the tourist resorts is the Playa del Famara. This is a very authentic beach. It's one thing that I need to say is if it's windy, don't go here because then it gets way too windy. It's very popular with people liking to do surfing, kite surfing and windsurfing. They also build these kind of like little shelters here to protect you from the wind. So if it does get a little bit windy, there is a way to escape it. But normally I would say if it's a windy day, don't go here because it will just be too windy. If you like to rough it and you like something truly authentic and original, then it's a great beach for you. On number two, near the Playa Blanca, you have the Playa de Montaña Roja. This is a really nice, smallish beach with like a nice little beach bar next to it, just outside of the Playa Blanca area. If the beaches in the Playa Blanca get too busy, especially in high season, this might be a really good place to escape to. There's like a little beach bar here. It's got a really smallish, compactish feel, really nice. So if you like that kind of feel, then come to the Playa de Montaña Roja. There's just one quick thing you need to know when you first come here. You might think that it's a private beach. It is not. It's only the sunbeds and stuff that belong to the hotel. So those you cannot use, but the beach is for anyone to use. On my number one, near the Playa Blanca in Lanzarote, you have the Playa Papagayo. This is a very famous beach. You can drive there by car, but then do know you need to bring 3 or 4 euros in cash to pay the tax, as this is a nature reserve and you cannot just use the roads. You have to pay a small like entry tax and parking tax. You can also walk here from the Playa Blanca, but it's quite a far walk. I would not advise it for everyone, but it could be nice if you like to hike. Then do know that also to this beach, it's best to go actually on a windy day, because on a really sunny, non-windy days, everyone likes to go here and it feels just too crowded. But on the windy days, you don't have any wind on the actual beach, since it's in this kind of valley microclimate. But there's also on those days not so many tourists, because people then think it's not going to be good on the beach. So that is my quite little tip. If you like to go to the Playa Papagayo, this is the best time to go on a little bit windy day when other people normally won't.
So I talked a little bit about what to do and see in Mallorca. In this next part, I want to cover a little bit more about things I would avoid or things I wouldn't advise you to do, as I think it's quite important as well for you to know these things to get the most out of your holiday.
The aloe vera farms and shops or museums, whatever they might be called in Lanzarote, I'm personally not too big a fan of. Pretty much every organized excursion in Lanzarote includes some type of visit to an aloe vera farm or a museum. While these can be a bit interesting, some of the health claims made are not really backed up when you look them up online. Also, the visit always ends with some kind of a hard sell of aloe vera products, so I find this pressure not really something for me on holiday. I don't want to be sold a lot of things, so I try to advise these. My advice would be, if you think it's interesting, go and have a look, of course, but don't feel pressure to buy. All these places also have online shops where you can buy these products afterwards, and many of them also have free shipping to get it to you afterwards. So I definitely would advise you, if you want to go and have a look, have a look, but don't feel pressured to buy. Another thing I definitely want to warn you about, because it can ruin your entire holiday. It might sound a little bit silly, but I travel to lots of different holiday destinations. I spend a lot of time in the sun. I never have any problems, but on Lanzarote, I got burned straight away. It was a little bit of like this cloudy, windy day. And because there was a lot of wind on these days, it felt not so hot, but I got burned almost pretty much instantly. So do know that the weather can be a little bit surprising here, but not in a good way. If it's feeling a little bit windy or if it's a little bit cloudy, still put on the sunscreen. If not, you will burn yourself for the rest of your holiday on the first day. So Lanzarote is a pretty cheap place to rent a car if you do it right. If you rent it with the wrong company or if you do it in the wrong way, it will end up costing you a lot of money. I see this every time I come to Lanzarote. I see people in discussions and problems with the same companies in the airport. This is basically all day, every day with those companies. I know what to do and what not to do because I've been traveling to Lanzarote quite a lot, how to get a car and which companies to get them with. I have another video discussing this in more detail. Also have an article on my website where I discuss all the things to do and definitely not to do when renting a car, as well as the companies you should book and should not book with. So just to have you avoid this whole hassle of having extra charges and upselling and discussions. You don't want to be dealing with this. Renting a car in Lanzarote is a good thing to do. Just make sure you do it with the right companies.
In this next part, a quick guide of how to get from the Lanzarote airport to your hotel or resort fast, easy and cheap.
The first way to get from the Lanzarote airport to your hotel or resort is just to take the public bus or the public transportation. You can just buy the ticket on arrival at the actual bus, so it's very easy. Do know that for some destinations, like Costa de Gies, you will first have to stop in Arrecife and then transfer onto another bus. Also know that the buses don't arrive very late into the evening, so if your plane has a chance of being delayed or your plane arrives late, I would definitely not choose this option. Also, that it may stop quite far away from your hotel, especially if you're traveling to the Puerto del Carmen or the Playa Blanca, this is quite likely. As I mentioned, to take the public bus to the Costa de Gies, you will have to transfer into Arrecife, and altogether the two buses will cost you €3. If you're going to the destinations that are closer by the airport, like Matagorda and Puerto del Carmen, it's €1.4 normally the ticket. The furthest away destination is the Playa Blanca, and this one will cost you €4 per ticket. For most people, a better way, I think, is to take a shuttle bus, simply because you get dropped off at your hotel, so not at some random bus stop. Also know that it's normally the same price or an even better price, and that there's no need to transfer onto other buses, as well as many, many other benefits that these kind of buses have, like they will wait for you if your plane gets delayed and a lot more. Also know that you have to book these ones before online. This is the only drawback. You cannot get them at the airport if you haven't booked them before online, but booking before online is quite easy. The shuttle buses normally are €5 for all the destinations near the airport. This includes Costa de Gies, Arrecife, Matagorda, Puerto del Carmen and Puerto Cayero. If you want to go further away to the Playa Blanca, normally they're about €9. For the company I would advise, you can have a look on my website at checkedholidays.com/links. This is also the company I always use for shuttle buses. There you also find all the other companies I like to use when traveling. Taking a taxi is another great way, is definitely the fastest way of getting from the airport, Lanzarote Airport, to your hotel. Do know that this also comes, of course, at a higher price. If you're traveling four people, normally it's quite a good price. Do know that also there are always, when I come at Lanzarote Airport, long lines. I don't know why this is or if it's still like this at the moment that you will be traveling, but do keep in mind that this is always, when I was there were long lines waiting for the taxis. Also, that there is no fixed price, so if the taxi driver gets lost along the way or you have a lot of traffic jams along the way, the price will go up. And for small children, normally there are no child safety seats, so keep this in mind also. For all of these reasons, to avoid all these negative things and just get there in a fast and a good priced way, is to go book before online a taxi. Pricing for the Costa de Gies taxi is about €20. It's €10 for the closer by destination like Arrecife, €18 for Puerto del Carmen and Puerto Cayero, and the furthest away is Playa Blanca. This one is normally €45. In the weekends or in the evenings, it's more expensive. Do keep this in mind. Also for taxis, the companies I would advise you to book with, you can find on my website, checkedholidays.com/links.
If you're not 100% sure if this is the right holiday destination for you, feel free to have a look at any of these other videos. I have 250 more guides here on YouTube at the moment. And of course, you can also find many more on my website at checkedholidays.com.